Hello, Fred here. I want to welcome all the members of the Secret Silver Stacking Society. In this video, I want to just go over some recent investment moves and also some key points before I go into those investment moves or stacking moves, whatever you want to call it. I just want to talk about a few things because when I was younger, people would tell me different things, and some of it worked and some of it didn't work, you know. And I just want to share with you some important things that, you know, I found out not to be true. Now, a lot of people say, you know, young people say, I don't need life insurance. I don't need to think about life insurance. And a lot of people tell younger people, hey, life insurance, you don't need it. It's just an extra expense. Reality of it is, life insurance is something if you have children or you have funeral costs and things like that, you need to consider. So just because you're in your 20s and your kids are still young or something like that, you may want to get life insurance. Now, I'm not an expert. I can't tell you, is whole life better than term? A lot of people say term is better than whole life. But then I also see the other side of the coin where people borrow against their whole life to make investments in real estate and things like that. So I think the saying is, if you need life insurance, some life insurance is better than no life insurance, especially if you have children. So that's one, I guess, fallacy that's out there, that just because you're in your 20s or mid to late 20s, you don't need life insurance. You may need life insurance, and it could be an asset to you, especially if you can borrow against it, like with whole life. But, you know, like I said, some people prefer term, and that's fine too. So do your research, decide which is good. Nothing's promised. Tomorrow's not even promised. So I highly recommend, considering life insurance if you have a family or you want to cover your funeral expenses. At the very least, you should consider a plan, some kind of plan to cover your funeral costs so your family doesn't have to come out of pocket. Also, you may want a plan to cover your bills. Maybe you have bills. And it could be something simple as maybe $50 a month or $100 a month. You know, I know that may seem a lot. A lot of people say, well, I could stack more silver on that amount. But here's the thing. You don't want the burden passed on to your family to cover your bills or your funeral expenses. So it's just something to consider. There's different strategies and ways of doing it. I just wanted to bring it to your attention in this video. I was, working with people in their personal finances and helping them. So I know this is a common thing people don't think about or don't consider. And so many times you see, especially in the poorer communities or low-income communities, where they got to do car washes and, you know, drives at their church to raise money to pay for somebody's funeral. You know, it's expensive depending on how you want to be laid to rest. It can be very, very expensive, and you don't want that burden on your family. So that's just one thing. I think another thing is, I know everybody says Robert Kiyosaki, you know, he doesn't say save. Well, if you read some of his other material, Robert Kiyosaki even says, you shouldn't save to save. And I agree. Some of your money should be put away for investing, very conservative investments. I recently invested in some SafeMoon, and it's been all over the place. Just a couple days ago, it was really down heavily. I also got GMR. That was down like by 40%. And every day, ever since I bought it, it has been going down nonstop. Who knows if the coin is going to make it long term, but my point being is I shed it with silver being down and my crypto being down. I shed it about maybe $3,000, you know. The thing is, now what percentage of my wealth is that? It's a small percentage. So, you know, if you want to risk something, risk a small percentage. That's my point. Some of you guys can afford to lose $3,000, which is fine, you know. But at the same time, that was just with cryptos and stuff. At the same time, you know, you got to take a chance, but you know, a small chance won't hurt you now. Can I afford to lose 3,000? Not really. I know I say it the way I said it initially sounds like it, and in some ways I can, in some ways I can't, but I wanted to learn, and I view it as paying for an education in crypto. I'm still learning. I put a small amount of money into crypto, and I doubled that money. So I was trying to do the same thing with a larger amount of money. So we'll see. We'll see how it goes. But the thing is, saving is a good thing. Not just saving just to save. You don't want to save just for an emergency. I think, like I've talked about before, saving, you know, a year's worth of earned income, that's a great goal. The reason I say that is because look at 2020 with the pandemic, how people were out of work for almost that whole time, or the 2008 housing crash, people losing their job and their houses. If you have a year's worth of income, you know you have enough money to weather that storm, to get a new skill trade, or anything. You know what I mean? So, you know, I think, like I was trying, my point being is saving is good. You can take a risk, maybe 10% of your money, like I did. You know, hey, I still have some of that 3,000, but the point being is some of it is evaporated because the market was down for me for a while. It may come back, we'll see. But my point being is net worth, that's a lot of that's net worth loss, not a physical cash loss. It's more of a net worth loss, but that's a whole nother subject. But my point being is, you know, hey, if you know, put away a lot of money and you decide to invest, I think a portion of your savings should always go towards investing. I think nothing's wrong with being conservative, especially when you're first starting out. Is a 401k bad? I don't think a 401k is bad for the average for investor, for the person just starting out, for the person who wants to invest in something that in the long term is better than nothing. A 401k is better than nothing. Just like I was saying, life insurance or some kind of plan to pay for your funeral expenses is better than nothing. Even if you're a single person, like I was saying before, even if you're single, you should have something put aside for your funeral expenses, like some form of insurance or something like that. Because, you know, like I said, tomorrow's not promised, but I don't want to go on the same rant. I just want to say that, you know, life insurance or some form of insurance to pay for funeral expenses, saving's very important, especially if you're not where you want to be. I'm not a millionaire. But you know, because of that financial risk I took to invest in cryptos and silver, I got to rebuild my savings up because I spent some savings quite a bit on cryptos. And I'm not going to tell you my whole portfolio because I promised my family I wouldn't do that. But I will say that it was a tough lesson. Even though we're having some up days in crypto, I'm still not up what I lost. So, you know, it's a tough lesson. You know, I have been investing in a lot of altcoins. A lot of people say, well, Fred, why don't you own Bitcoin? Bitcoin could go up to $1 million and hey, I may miss out, but I like the idea of altcoins and staking. And I have yet to find a way to stake, Bitcoin. Maybe there's other, exchanges that allow you to do that. But I haven't been able to do that at this point in time. So I've been just staking with altcoins. It's riskier. Like I said, I've lost a lot of money in it. In some ways, it's not a lot. In some ways, it is, you know. But I'm sure I'll bounce back because It was a smaller percentage of my wealth, but I'm rebuilding my savings up. I did buy some silver and I invested in a computer, so I'm going to start working on the ebook. I think I talked about that in the last video. But yeah, guys, I'm still hanging in there. I'm still in the fight. I still think silver stacking isn't a bad deal. Premiums, even though spot price went down, premiums went up again. And it's like, I don't know, I feel like the dealers are trying to play a game, it feels like, because they know the games where a lot of people are waiting for spot to go down and run out and buy silver. They know that now. And my thing is, what I'm seeing is premiums are going up. And with premiums going up, to cover their losses and we have to pay for it, just seems kind of like a scam to me. But like I said, I talked about this a long time ago. I don't want to spend $40 for silver. And it's starting to get to that point where you're paying $40. I paid that for a couple of Libertads. I don't want to. I'm starting to get very weary of paying close to $40 because years ago, when silver hit $40 an ounce, I bought it at that price. This was when Mike Maloney was pumping silver, and I bought it at that price, and I lost a lot of money because it didn't go back for what, almost seven, eight, nine, until now years. You know what I mean? So, do what makes sense investing. You know what I mean? Don't bet against the tide. I tried to bet against the tide, and sometimes the tide is low tide, sometimes it's high tide. That's the same with markets. Sometimes you're in a bull market, sometimes you're in a bear market. Buy low, sell high, right? So if you're buying in a bull market, if you don't know how to play the game, you better be very careful because the market could collapse. And it happened to me with silver. And it can happen with other investments. And then a low market or a bad market is a good time to buy, but keep in mind you don't want to catch a falling knife and get cut on the way down, where you may think you're buying at a bottom, but the bottom may not be fully reached, it may have further to go. That's what I mean. Okay, guys, this video's gone on for a long time. I could go on and on about this stuff, but I want to keep saying that Silver 5150 says, just 20 ounces to your name keeps you 99% ahead of the game. And as I say, just 20 ounces to your name of silver makes you a member of the secret silver stacking society. Take care. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.